Stay tuned for a very special reading of In the Time of the Dinosaurs by William Wise, illustrated by Louis Zax, as read by Nick Knack. Millions and millions of years ago, the world was very warm, much warmer than it is now. There was never any winter then. There was never any snow. Warm rain fell on the land. Even the sea was warm. In this warm world lived animals called dinosaurs. Some of them were the biggest animals that ever walked the land. They were the kings of the world for millions and millions of years. In the days of the dinosaurs, there were no men. So no man has ever seen a living dinosaur. Or lady, either. But we now know what kind of animals the dinosaurs were. We know because we found their bones. These bones have told us many things about the dinosaurs. We know how the dinosaurs lived. Some dinosaurs lived near the water. Some dinosaurs lived away from the water on dry land. And some dinosaurs were just big assholes, like this one. We know what the dinosaurs ate. Some dinosaurs ate only plants, like the way horses and cows eat grass now. Some dinosaurs ate the other animals the way lions eat other animals now. We know how large the dinosaurs were. Some of them were bigger than any animal you've ever seen, but some of them were as small as chickens. The dinosaurs who liked the water lived near ponds, or they lived near warm, slow-moving rivers. Many green plants grew there, and the dinosaurs liked to eat them. This was one of the first dinosaurs. He was very big. His body was as big as a truck or a small airplane. He had a very long neck. He had a very long tail. He had a very long name. His name was Brontosaurus. Brontosaurus liked the water. He stayed in the water as much as he could. It was easy for him to walk in the water, but it was hard for him to walk on land because he was so heavy. Brontosaurus found much of his food in the water, and he needed a lot of food because he was so big. Brontosaurus was safe in the water, but he was not safe on land. There was another dinosaur on the land that wanted to eat him. This dinosaur was called Allosaurus. When Allosaurus came near, Brontosaurus ran away. He ran through the mud. He splashed through the water. Allosaurus could not swim, so Allosaurus could not follow Brontosaurus into the deep water. When Brontosaurus got to the deep water, he was safe. Some of the first dinosaurs were much smaller than Brontosaurus. They could run much faster. This dinosaur was 10 feet long, but he only stood as tall as a man. He was called Camptosaurus. He lived near the water too. When Allosaurus came, he ran away. He ran behind the trees, or he ran quickly through the mud and the water if it wasn't very deep. Allosaurus, who sank in the mud, could not catch him there. Starting to think Allosaurus was kind of a chump. This dinosaur was called Ornitholestes. He was not very tall. He was about as tall as you are. That's actually pretty short if we're talking about Nick Knack. He could run very fast, though. He could hide behind trees or plants because he was so small. Some of the first dinosaurs did not live near the water. One of these was Stegosaurus. He lived on dry land and ate plants there. Stegosaurus was one of the first dinosaurs to have armor. He had his armor on his back. You can see how that armor went from his head to his tail. This armor helped keep Stegosaurus safe. Stegosaurus had a tail that kept him safe too. On the end of his tail, there were four long spikes. No other dinosaur wanted to get near those spikes, not even Allosaurus. So if he was not very hungry, Allosaurus left Stegosaurus alone. Hell no, Allosaurus. Stegosaurus would jack you up. Not all the dinosaurs lived at the same time. Brontosaurus and Allosaurus and many other dinosaurs lived for millions and millions of years. Then one by one, they died out. Brontosaurus died out. Allosaurus died out. Stegosaurus died out too. Dead. But many new dinosaurs came to take their place. This was one of those new dinosaurs. He lived near the water. His name was Trachodon. Trachodon was a big dinosaur. He was as tall as a tall tree. He ate only plants and leaves. Trachodon had a long, wide tail. He could swim very well with the help of that tail. Trachodon. Many of the new dinosaurs lived near the water. This dinosaur lived on dry land. He was called Strathiomyus. Look at him eat those fruits or something. Nuts or maybe some dinosaur's testicles. Ouch. This wonky looking MF-er had no teeth. He ate only plants and leaves and other soft things. To be safe, he'd run and hide. Some of the new dinosaurs had armor to keep them safe. This dinosaur was called Paleoskinkus. He ate plants and leaves and had very heavy armor on his back. His tail had spikes on both sides. No other dinosaur wanted to come near an animal like that with a tail like that. Nope, no one wanted a piece of Paleoskinkus, that's for sure. Some of the new dinosaurs had horns. This dinosaur had three horns. He had a little horn on the end of his nose. He had two big horns over his eyes. His name was Triceratops. Triceratops was a big animal. He was much bigger than a horse or a cow. He had small teeth. He ate only plants and leaves. And a very fine disposition, too. Kind of nice to cuddle with. But because of his horns, Triceratops was not afraid of any other animal. He was not even afraid of the most terrible dinosaur of all. The most terrible dinosaur that ever walked the earth. Tyrannosaurus. Tyrannosaurus was the last of the dinosaurs. He ate other animals. He was one bad MF. He stood over 20 feet tall. He could look over the top of a tall tree. His nose to his tail, he was almost 50 feet long. He was as long as a big truck. His teeth were as long as a man's hand. And his mouth was full of teeth. He was the most terrible animal that ever lived on the land. When Tyrannosaurus came, all the other dinosaurs ran. Some ran into the water. Some ran under plants or behind trees. All the dinosaurs ran. All but one. Triceratops did not run. Triceratops stood right where he was. He saw Tyrannosaurus. He saw the terrible teeth. But Triceratops was not afraid. If Tyrannosaurus was looking for a fight, Triceratops would give him one. Most times, Tyrannosaurus went away and left Triceratops alone. There are other dinosaurs to catch and eat. Other dinosaurs that are not as big as Triceratops. Other dinosaurs that did not have two big horns. But if Tyrannosaurus was very, very hungry, he stayed to fight. And what a terrible fight that must have been. The most terrible fight two animals ever, ever had. Many times, Tyrannosaurus won. Many times he was too strong for Triceratops. But not always. There were many times when Triceratops won too. Triceratops must have been a brave animal. Any animal must have been brave to stand fight with the king of the dinosaurs, Tyrannosaurus. Now here's where this book gets depressing. Then after millions and millions of years, something happened to the dinosaurs. All at once, they began to die out. But this time, no new dinosaurs were there to take their place. Trachodon died out. Brave Triceratops died out. Even Tyrannosaurus, the most terrible animal that ever lived, died out too. At last, there was not one dinosaur left in the world. No one knows why all the dinosaurs died out. All we can do is guess what might have happened. We know the world had become a little colder. It was still warm, but not as warm as they would have been before. Maybe the dinosaurs could only live when it was very warm, and they died out when the world grew just a little cooler. Or maybe something else happened. We know that when Triceratops and Tyrannosaurus were still alive, new animals came into the world. They were no bigger than rabbits, but they liked to eat eggs. They liked to eat the eggs of dinosaurs. Maybe these assholes or these animals ate so many dinosaur eggs that the dinosaurs died out. Maybe the biggest animals in the world died out because of what some little animals did. We just aren't sure. All we know is that the dinosaurs lived for millions and millions of years. For millions of years, they were the kings of the world. Then, they were gone. And no animal like them have ever been seen again.